MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Should be a good one here this afternoon between the Sky Sox and the Kansas City Royals. It's baseball, it's The Show, and it comes your way next. Jacob Junis gets the ball for the Royals in this one. What's your take on him, Dan?
You know, Matt, I think this guy really is looking for a redeemer in this one. Went into the sixth inning in this last start, couldn't quite get out of the sixth, end up taking the loss, and I'm sure that hurt, and he's expecting a lot more out of himself in this start here today.
So that'll bring in Mookie Betts, and we are ready for some daytime baseball.
Colorado Springs, the right fielder, Mookie Betts.
Here comes the first pitch. Fastball just misses. That's ball one. These Kansas City Royals entering play this afternoon, guys. They've been fairly punchless of late, losing last time out and, in fact, dropping six of their last seven.
Yeah, Matty V, it hasn't been a very good homestand. And D-Row, through the first five games of this set, 1-4, that's not going to get it done at this level.
Yeah, and have lost in a variety of ways, whether it be on some bad pitching, some mistakes in the middle of the zone, untimely defense, not swinging the bats well. They have to find a way to get this win today.
Outside, 3-0 now. Now the pitch. That one's in there. 3-1.
Finally got one over. Nothing worse than starting the game with a four-pitch walk.
And that misses for ball four. So it's a five-pitch walk to get us started here this afternoon.
And don't forget, he lost his last time out, so he wants to get off on the right foot here. The last thing he wanted was to walk the leadoff man.
Digging in, Corey Dickerson. First pitch of the at-bat on its way.
Yeah, he made up his mind early to take the first pitch because that thing was right down the middle.
Betts gets his lead at first, nobody out. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball. And there is our officiating crew in this one, calling balls and strikes, Mr. Freddie Ferguson.
You know, this is one of the guys behind the dish, Freddie Ferguson, Dan, that the rookies are going to have a tough time with. If you've played in the league for a little bit, you understand that he's got his own zone.
You touched on it, D-Row. I think he rewards the veteran players, not only pitchers, but position players. He makes the younger players, he makes them earn their keep.
And now we'll look at the starting lineup for the visitors in this one. Mark DeRosa, what's your take on him this afternoon on the road?
Matty, you take a look at this lineup, and they're frustrating to watch at times because they ground into the most double plays in the league. You want to talk about a pitcher's best friend. You finally get a guy on first base, and you're coming unglued first pitch down below the knees, grounding into a double play and bailing everybody out. I need better approaches out of this lineup today.
The 1-0 home. Bases are empty here with two men out. Off the outside that time as the breaking ball can't catch the zone.
This is a good at bat so far here with two away. If you're going to go down 1-2-3, at least make the guy work for it. He's doing that, and he's even gotten himself into a good hitter's count now.
Full count now, 3-2. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. And this is on the ground for Merrifield at second. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. So they're held in check here this half of the inning. And now the Royals get their first shot in a scoreless ball game. Madison Bumgarner starts the game on the mound for the third and final game of the series. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, this guy's had a solid year up to this point. It's not an easy thing to do in baseball this year with all the high-scoring games, but this guy has an ERA of sub-3, and that's saying something. If he continues to do that, I think you're going to see a really good performance out of him in this one.
Striding in, Adalberto Mondesi, and he really thrives in the batter's box here at home. Something to keep an eye on in this one. Here's the first pitch to him. So guys are visitors as they take the field following a scoreless top half. 4-2 over their last six games, including a win last time out.
Matty, we've seen some good baseball in the first two games that is set, and expect another close one here. Both of the first two games decided by one run.
You know, D-Row, when you get in these series like this, when one run means so much, you like to be able to be the team to score first, but both these games have been very close, and it's going to boil down to who gets the big hits in the seventh, eighth, and ninth inning.
Lined hard and deep down the left field line. Ah, but he just missed his extra bases. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
Gallagher.
At the plate now, Cam Gallagher. As he'll look at a fastball in there on the outer half, it's 0-1. Now here's the pitch. Bases are empty, one man out. Now a curveball misses inside.
He didn't look overly fooled right there because a lot of pitchers will go to the breaking stuff 0-2, but he certainly looked ready for a breaker on that pitch.
The 1-2. Is looked at for ball number two.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
Hit back up the middle, reined in. On to first, and Bumgarner's rolling right through him here. Two away now.
Batting first, the second baseman,
Whit Merrifield next to hit. Swinging it well so far in this series. He's 3-for-9. Bumgarner's ready. Here's the first pitch.
Ball left outside.
The 1-0.
Not surprised he's laid on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch. Wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
Here it comes on 1-1. Fastball laid off well below the knees. Two out, nobody on. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. But this will land untouched. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. Fouled off. Popped him up. The Shields has a play. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. KC down in order, and this is still a nothing-nothing ball game. And here's the switch hitting catcher Yasmani Grandal. His batting average on the year down to the 240 mark entering play. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. They haven't played perfectly as it's hit on the ground. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and the leadoff man set down to start the second.
The left fielder, number 9, Mike Yastrzemski.
Coming to the plate now, Mike Yastrzemski. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch.
0-1.
Still looking for our first hit in the ball game. A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. Nothing in two count, and the pitch.
That's a ball. One ball, two strikes.
And it's fouled away.
Great job of running that fastball in on his hands right there with two strikes. Even though the batter's able to foul that one off, he's set up for almost anything in this pitcher's arsenal.
Ball. Nearly got the inside, but ruled a ball.
Well, two straight fastballs inside haven't put him away, so now it'll be interesting to see what he turns to.
Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
To be honest with you, I'm a little bit more afraid of the guy on deck than the guy that's up right now. If I'm on the mound, I want this guy up right now. He's the guy that's got to beat me.
Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. He's around first, heading for two. And he is in at second base with a one-out double.
That is it. The first baseman, Luke Ford.
Stepping in now, Luke Voigt, as the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Enters play here at 279. 6 home runs, 18 driven in. Now the 1-0. A swing and a miss, strike one.
That's just too much velocity upstairs to get good wood on it. It's going to have to lower his sights.
One one home. Popped up. O'Hearn over to his right. Two down.
That's exactly what they wanted out of that pitch up in the zone. They took him up the ladder and he couldn't get up to it. So that was an easy pop out. Well executed pitch there.
Stepping up to the plate, Bo Bichette. First at bat for him in this one. He was 1-for-4 with a double in the ball game last night. Comes set. Now the pitch.
1-0.
That hook stayed up in the zone. You can see he struggled with that curveball early. He's trying to find that release point with his off-speed pitches. Love to see if he can find the feel for that thing moving forward.
No score here as we play inning number two. And a fastball here that's taken for ball two. Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0. Three balls, no strikes.
Stealing that strike on 3-0 was important, but you don't want to miss over the heart of the plate in this situation. I got to believe he's going to be way more aggressive right here.
Yeah. That's in there, and it'll run the count to full, 3-2. And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work.
Well, this guy's been prone to giving up walks in bunches, and that's already two walks here in the early going. We'll see if this continues to be an issue for him as this start continues.
Stepping in, Delino DeShields. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Looking to wiggle out of this. Here it is.
Count 1-0.
Two men are on with two men out. And he misses again, 2-0.
Got to find a way to execute either a good fastball down and away or flip something off speed for a strike. You cannot miss over the harder plate in these situations. The hitter is on high alert.
Got himself a 2-0 fastball there, but he couldn't connect. 2-1.
This pitcher's bringing it with some high velo. You better get that front foot down early and get ready, or he's going to throw it right by you.
And he misses again, ball three.
There isn't a hitter alive that doesn't love hitting in fastball counts like 3-1. It's usually a pretty fruitful count in terms of getting a pitch to drive.
And he fouls this one off. Two down, runners at first and second. Now a ball hit foul down the line in right and in amongst the fans. He's set. The 3-2 pulled high in the air out to left field. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Half of the second set to go, set to get his day started, Jorge Soler. And it's been a real struggle for him with the bat so far this year, looking to get things turned around in a hurry. Here comes the first pitch. Taken, and that one catches the bottom part of the strike zone. And he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two. And he goes up the ladder on him, but he lays off 1-2.
Love the high heater right there to raise the hitter's sights. Let's see if he buries something in the dirt right here.
Fouled away. Another 1-2 delivery. Now another pitch is hit foul and headed for the seats, so the count will stay put at 1-2. And the pitch. Boy, good cutting action to that pitch as that's the first out of the inning.
He put up a pretty good battle at the plate right there. They finally get him on a 1-2 pitch, but you could see that he wasn't laying down without a fight. He really made the pitcher earn that strikeout.
And up steps Salvador Perez as he'll go after the first pitch and line one into right field for a base hit. And this one scoots all the way to the wall. Throw into second, and he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two base hit.
Wow, he almost blew that fastball by him, but he shows some quick hands to catch up to it and drive it down the opposite line. Didn't keep it fair by much, but he did, and that's a nice two bagger.
Standing in, Michael Franco. Lifetime numbers against Bumgarner. He's hitting .429. He's taken him deep once. For First pitch coming. Here it is.
Tried to check it, and it's 0-1.
Here comes the 0-1. Bumgarner, 30 years of age, he was selected in the first round back in the draft of 2007.
Yeah, Matty, they certainly got it right when they drafted this guy. He has turned himself into an absolute superstar. Everybody knows this guy's name, and kids are buying his jerseys.
It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. But this one will bend foul. Had plenty of distance, though, as it landed in the upper deck. Ready on 1-2. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
Bumgarner sets. First pitch on its way. Hit hard to the right side. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Here's the 0-2. Fouled off. Bottom of the second here with no score. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. One left for Kansas City. We'll move to the third with no score. Matt Vasgersian back with Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac as Kevin Kiermaier settles in to start the inning. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. The windup and the 0-1. Now a swing and a miss at a slider for a strike. And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. That was a nasty looking slider that time.
Yeah, that was really well executed, Matt. A classic strikeout pitch. You think it's fastball middle in, then it starts bearing in on your back leg, and unless you hit it out front, there's nothing much you can do with that.
Here's Mookie Betts, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. He worked the walk to open up the ball game. The 0-1 delivery.
One ball, one strike.
Hit hard up the middle. Merrifield brings it in. And the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play.
Now, this is not an easy play when you have to range to your right. He really didn't have a chance to get his feet set, so this is all arm. Nicely done.
So striding forward now, Corey Dickerson. First offering on its way. Way inside with that one, a pretty easy take there.
This could be a huge win for the guy on the mound if he's able to get out of this inning 1-2-3 and start fresh next inning with the middle of the order.
This is pulled into right. He leaps, but he can't get it. It's down for extra bases.
And now he'll get into scoring position with two away. Well, that's why they call baseball a game of inches.
Yeah, you're right, Matt. He showed some serious hops, but not serious enough. He goes up high for it with the good leap, but he just can't bring it in, and that allows him to cruise into second with a good piece of hitting.
In now is Anthony Rendon. Fly ball out toward left center field. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. Danger averted following the two-out double. We've played two and a half. No score on the show.
We're back as the Royals prepare for their at-bats here in the third. This lineup has been a huge bright spot for the ball club this season. Entering the day, they rank among the best teams in the league in stolen bases. A lot of teams these days rely more on big swings of the bat to generate offense. But when I asked a member of the coaching staff about their approach on the bases, he told me they're simply playing into their strengths. He said they have a lot of really athletic guys, so it would be misguided to not be aggressive and force the other guys to prove they can stop them. Something to keep an eye on as this one moves forward.
Thank you, Heidi. Here comes the first pitch. Strike swinging, timing a little off on that one. Bumgarner ready with the 0-1. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Yastrzemski's got it, and there's one gone. Into the box now, Dyron Blanco, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. And now a pitch on the way. And he'll look at a first pitch curveball that's in the dirt. It's ball one. Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score. Now a big fastball, and he's well behind it with the swing. Ripped down the line, but a foul ball, one and two now. Now the pitch. Liner toward right center. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
I mean, that fires me up right there. Opposite field knock. And in today's game, where every manager is employing hundreds of shifts, to watch this batter go the other way was special.
Into the box now, Adalberto Mondesi, as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. Good fastball as he gets the swing and a miss. This is swung on and missed, his fifth strikeout already, and there are two gone in the inning. Didn't mess around much in that at-bat then.
No, that was pretty impressive, Matt. I really like a pitcher that trusts and works off his fastball. Right there, he decided he didn't need to use anything else. Three straight heaters and go grab some bench.
And now they've got him in a rundown. The tag, and they'll get him at second, and with that, the side is retired. Nothing doing for the Royals. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. Here's the catcher, Yasmani Grandal.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings with no score. You'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some base runners on and get him in, but that hasn't been the case.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Ball one. Count 1-0.
The 1-0. And it's fouled away. Swing and a liner, and he is going to have extra bases to start the fourth. Legs churning, he's headed for second, and this throw gets away from him.
Let's slow this one down and take another look. Great camera angle here, looking straight down the left field line. You see him take that inside route to the ball, his hands stay back, and he goes oppo to find himself at second.
At the plate, Mike Yastrzemski. As the first pitch sinker misses to him, it's ball one. Still all zeros in the run column here in the fourth inning. Dan, does this continue or does somebody score here?
Oh, you have to love it. You know, Matt, we have so many of these games that are 12 to 10 and 9 to 8. It's nice to see a low scoring pitcher's duel for once.
Inside, and he falls behind the hitter now 2-0.
Yeah, I think it's pretty clear they don't want to challenge this guy right here, but working around a guy can come back to bite you at times.
A runner at second, nobody out. Three and oh now.
This is a spot you like to be in as a good hitter. Runners in scoring position and count leverage in your favor.
Here it comes, the 3-0. And he misses there for ball four. So runners are at first and second now with nobody out.
Now batting, the first baseman, Luke.
Digging in for his second at bat, Luke Voigt. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Soler is there. Makes the play, one away.
Now batting, shortstop, Bo Bichette.
So two men are on with one man out. And into bat next, the legacy, Bo Bichette. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Miller will range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the second out of the inning.
Now batting, the second baseman, the lineman, DeShields.
And here's the second generation big leaguer, Delino DeShields. He's 0 for 1 thus far. First pitch coming, here it is. Now a fastball a bit too low here, it's ball one. A bouncer to the left side, scooped up, throw in time, and the side is retired. Ready for another chance? Cam Gallagher is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
Cam Gallagher.
First pitch of the at bat. Skied into very shallow right. There to look it in his bets, and that's out number one.
Now back, second baseman.
One away for the Royals here in the fourth, and that'll bring up the second baseman Whit Merrifield. He's ready. Here's the first offering, and he takes a pitch that's ruled a strike at the knees. Pretty liberal strike zone there. It's 0-1, and he lays off for ball one.
Hey, that backdoor breaking ball just missed. He had a chance to run it to 0-2.
Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. Lifted down the line and left. And that's going to land foul. Ready on 1-2. Lined but speared on a hop. In time to first, and there are two away.
Can't hit a ball any harder than that. I mean, this ball gets on him in a heartbeat. Nice job to stay with it, though, and then make the out at first.
In is Jorge Soler. Comes into this at bat 0-1 in the ball game. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
Nope.
The 1-0. Now a ball lined toward the gap in left center. And that'll get down out there near the wall. The throw is wild and it gets away.
Everyone knows that this guy's numbers are not where he wants them to be so far this year. But you never know by that swing. He looked fluid and confident driving that pitch for a double. We'll see if that gets him going a bit.
Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez. This will look at a changeup that drops below the knees for ball one. It was a double for him in his first turn at the plate. That evens it up 1-1. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. And he fouls this one off. Breaking ball there is down. Good job of laying off. It's back to 2-2.
Good job to lay off that 1-2 breaking ball. Put himself right back in this at bat.
He's set. The 2-2. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of giving in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open, it's not the end of the world if you do. You still need to make a quality pitch.
And the cutter can't find the zone as he surrenders the base on balls here.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that with too much.
Digging in to try it again, Michael Franco. Two men on, two away here in the fourth. Bumgarner sets. Here comes the first pitch. Fouled away. Ready with the 0-1. And he misses with it, 1-1. And there's ball two now.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Franco ahead with a 3-1 count now.
Time to wake up the offense right here. 3-1 count, all in on something over the heart of the plate.
Oh, he had a go at one there, but this is fouled off to the right as the count draws full. Ready with the payoff pitch. Hit softly on the ground to third. Right to him. On to first, and the Royals can't cash in as the inning is over. Royals strand a pair. Through four. Still tied. Nothing, nothing. So here's Kevin Kiermaier. 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
Colorado Springs. The center fielder, Kevin.
Here comes the first pitch. Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0. Chop foul right by home plate, and it's a ball and a strike. Got caught lunging there as this one's fouled away. Hit sharply on the ground to the left. And that's a base hit, so the pressure's on to open up the inning.
I don't know what side of the fence I fall on, boys. Old school, new school. I think I kind of stand right along that fence. But one thing that gets me jacked up is watching guys grind down in the count and drive base hits the other way.
Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring up Mookie Betts. First pitch on its way.
That's a great call right there. Fastball away with a guy who's got some jets on first base. Almost like a hybrid pitch out. Great for a catcher if that guy's running. Easy transfer throw to second base.
Now the 1-0. And here's a ball out towards straightaway center field. Blanco will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first.
Now batter, designated hitter, Corey Dickerson.
Digging in and looking for more, Corey Dickerson. 1-for-2 with a double on the ledger so far. First pitch of the at bat on its way, and a fastball is in there for strike one. Prior to the 0-1, here's a look to first and a dive, but he's back in there. On its way, the 0-1 pitch shoots this one over to first. That gets through, and he'll reach base again on his second base hit of the game. And he'll move up to third now. Runners at the corners here with one away.
The third baseman, number six.
This is their time right here. This starting pitcher has been on point all day. Runs have been at a premium. They have an opportunity to do something special right here.
And digging in next will be Anthony Rendon, as he will take a look at strike one on a fastball right down the pipe. Mm-hmm. fouled off. Runners are at first and third, one away. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
Well, their chances of pushing across a run took a pretty good hit after that strikeout. It's so much tougher to score a guy from third with two outs instead of one. Basically, you need a hit, or you need to get lucky with a wild pitch or a pass ball.
In now, Yasmani Grandal. Batting left-handed here as he takes a look at strike one. And facing right-handed pitching so far this season, Grandal is a batting line residing in the 230s.
He'd be the first to tell you he's not happy with his batting average this season, but he can beat you in a variety of different ways, and he has to because he wouldn't be here otherwise.
So far this season, Grandal has a slugging percentage a little over 425, a respectable number. Here's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone.
Man, this guy's had their number all game long. Up, down, in and out. He's pitching very well.
Ready with the 2-1. And a little self-preservation down at first as he pulls that one in to end the inning. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, I talked with the Kansas City manager during the inning break about the Royals' offensive production to this point. And he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said they've been chasing at pitches out of the zone all game, which obviously doesn't usually lead to good results. Until they start being more selective with their swings, he said they will continue to struggle.
All right, thanks, Heidi. Set now for the bottom of the fifth. Now at the plate, Ryan O'Hearn. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
Change up too low, and it's 1-0. The pitch and a strike to even the count, 1-1. Oh, they'll run this one in on him and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Oh, I love that pitch right there, up and in, jam sandwich.
On a good changeup, a swing and a miss, and he's set down on strikes for the second time today.
Wow, that's one of the toughest pitches in baseball to hit, right? That good straight changeup, El Cambio. There's not much you can do with that. You're going off of that arm speed and the ball, it just doesn't get there.
To the plate now, Anderson Miller. As he'll take a look at a strike on the outside corner, it's 0-1. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout. Line drive, that's a base hit into the right center field gap. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
I'll tell you, that's one of the first good swings we've seen anybody put on this guy so far. He's been throwing the ball really well, but that was one of the few mistakes we've seen him make.
Ready now, Dyron Blanco, 1-for-1 after a single his first time up.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield, he's going to wave them.
First pitch coming, here it is. There's a breaking ball that couldn't quite catch the inside. Blanco, a Cuban-born ball player. He's in his rookie year here at the big league level. is set, and the 1-0 pitch.
Boy, you don't see that very often out of a rookie. That's a 2-0 count, and both of those pitches were really close. This guy has a pretty good eye.
Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0. No runs, four hits, and no errors so far for the Royals. And he drops a changeup right down Broadway for a called strike. Three and two, a full count to the Royals center fielder. Good battle, count remains full. He'll try it again, 3-2. Swing and a miss, and they come back from a 3-0 count to sit him down on strikes, and there are two gone.
Anytime you get rookies just breaking into the big leagues, you have to expect a certain amount of this. There aren't any easy at-bats at this level, and you really have to learn how to slow the game down in your head because everything feels like it's so much faster up here.
At the plate now, Adalberto Mondesi, and he'll watch one miss up and away for a ball, 1-0. No runs, four hits, and no errors so far for the Royals. Now a ball lined to the left side, but foul. A 2-1 count to the leadoff hitter for Kansas City. Swing and a liner, but a good play by the first baseman to spear this one, and that'll retire the side. Royals leave one. Sixth inning coming up, still zip, zip. So striding in, Mike Yastrzemski. It was a walk in his last trip.
Mike Yastrzemski.
First pitch of the at bat on its way. The wind up and the 0-1. Popped him up. Franco shading to his right. He's got it, one away. So the shutout still intact here in the sixth as we check out the league leaderboard for team ERA. And we find that these guys are currently third best in the AL in that department. Digging in once again, Luke Voit, 0-for-2 here to start the afternoon. Here comes the first pitch. Off the plate and away there, one ball, no strikes. Line drive to left, and that's in for a base hit. Make it a 1-for-3 game so far.
Yeah, he's got the outs when he's needed them and seems to be really comfortable pitching from the stretch. Hard to keep that up over several innings, though.
Standing in now, Bo Bichette. He swings and grounds it to short. There's Merrifield on to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. For the last half of the inning. Now to the plate, Cam Gallagher. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Here comes the first pitch.
Nope, that's foul.
Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. A ball and two strikes. Popped up. Rendon is there. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
The batter number 15, second baseman, Whit Merrifield.
Coming to the plate now, Whit Merrifield. He was a ground-out victim last time up. First pitch coming. Here it is. In there for strike one. One out, nobody on. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
His command has been outstanding so far, hitting nearly all of his spots, and that's been a big factor why he's been so successful up to this point.
And here's a ball hit in the air, but this will land untouched. Hit back toward the mound, and that'll find its way into center field for a one out hit.
Well, you know what? Good hitters are good hitters for a reason, D-Row. And to be able to hang in there on an 0-2 pitch and still be able to get a base hit, this guy's about as good as it gets.
Yeah, I'm blown away by this guy, Dan. You wouldn't know if you showed up. You wouldn't know if it's 2-0, 3-1, 0-2. Counts do not matter. This guy trusts in his craft.
A dive, but he's back. Into the box now, Jorge Soler. Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1. 1-for-2 in the ball game thus far. Bumgarner ready with the 0-1.
That one looked like it could easily have gone the other way. There's a big difference between 0-2 and 1-1. But now this next pitch probably becomes the biggest of the at-bat.
Runner at first here, one man out. Runner goes for second. Strike taken, the throw. It's going to be far too late. That's a stolen base. Struck him out. Good pitch there as he registers his 8th punch out of the ball game.
Boy, there's nothing better from a pitcher standpoint than watching that high fastball, a high piece of cheese swung at and missed. That pitch looks so inviting to hit, but it's awfully tough to put in play.
At the plate, Salvador Perez, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. That misses wide. One ball and one strike. And he misses 2-1. Gets the sign, the 2-1.
Well, he snapped that breaking ball off really nice. He'll do well to keep putting it there.
The 2-2. And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. Back-to-back strikeouts keep him out of danger. On to the back third here this afternoon, and we've got it for you on the show. Now batting, Delino DeShields. He'll start the seventh, and Dan, as a former pitcher yourself, you must be enjoying this. Lots of good pitching and defense today.
Well, that's one of the keys. We're seeing a lot of strikes. We're seeing a lot of swings. We're seeing some great plays on defense. This has been a snappy one up to this point.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
Hey, this guy's done a better job than expected. He's made some bad pitches in the strike zone, but so far he hasn't gotten hurt by them.
The 0-1 delivery. On a line, that's a base hit.
Now batting, the center fielder, Kevin Kiermaier.
Now here comes the Royal skipper up the stairs on his way to the mound. And he's going to motion for the bullpen, as that'll be all for his starter this afternoon. He'll depart with our score tied, and he'll still be accountable for the runner at first. And the best he can do is a no decision in this one. Jesse Hahn comes on now, and he'll take over with nobody out in inning number 7.
Number 32, Jesse Hahn.
Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier, as he will take strike 1 on the fastball here. No balls in the strike. He's 1-for-2 in this one. Now the 0-1. Grounded up the first baseline. The second for 1. On to first, but not in time as he beats it out.
That was kind of a high degree of difficulty play that time. You see the off-balance throw to second base, and he couldn't get a lot on it, but they did get the out.
So a runner at first now with one away, and up next, one of the terrific talents in the game, Mookie Betts. From the stretch. And it's fouled away. Here's a little chopper up the middle. Mondesi brings it in. There's Merrifield. But one's all they were ever going to get, and the inning will continue.
And kids, this is why you always go hard into second base. Could have been an easy double play ball, but the slide really impacts the throw to first, and they wind up only getting one out on the play. Good, aggressive, legal slide that time.
Striding forward now is the DH, Corey Dickerson, 2-for-3 with a double on his line so far. Before the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. And again a throw, and the runner back. First offering on its way. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. Ball 2 now. Hahn has a good reputation for preventing the long ball. One swing can change the complexion of the ball game when you're coming in late, but he rarely lets that happen. Part of what makes him as effective as he is. The 2-0 is taken, strike 1.
Hey, you get 2-0, your eyes light up, but you're sitting in one spot, and he obviously didn't get it right there. But he still finds himself in a 2-1 count, ready to do some damage.
Line drive to center field. Blanco will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. At the plate, Michael Franco. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
Not sure if this is a powerhouse pitching performance by both teams or bad hitting, but as we're moving late into this one, it's about time somebody puts something together to try to score a run.
And here's a called strike at the knees. Don't think he liked that one too much, but it's 0-1. Now some action out in the bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander begin throwing. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. That's over, but low, it's a ball and a strike. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Kiermaier's got a read on it. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
Now back, number 56.
Standing in, Ryan O'Hearn. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
The 1-0 home. Misses, ball two.
Couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at-bat trying to get ahead and put himself at a good hitter's count.
2-1 to the Royals' first baseman. And through 6 1/3, he's about to hit the 100 pitch mark now.
Hey, you know, Matty V, this is all you can ask for as a manager in today's game in baseball. Very rarely do we see guys get through the seventh inning, so he's through the sixth here with one out, and Mark DeRosa, so far so good, a pretty decent outing.
Yeah, and I think it's going to be batter to batter here for the manager if he's going to continue to drive this hot hand or if he's going to go to the bullpen.
Now with the plate, Anderson Miller. It was a two-bagger for him in his last at-bat.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
We're moving along into the later innings, and this guy's throwing over 60% of his first pitches for strikes. He'd like to do a little bit more, but so far, so good.
Drill down the line. Bumgarner's ready. Here's the 0-2.
One ball, two strikes, down.
Well, he's thrown a lot of pitches in this one, but it's not like he's walking a bunch of guys. Only one free pass to this point, but they're still making him work really hard.
The 1-2. Misses for the second ball. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. The 2-2 one more time. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner. And that nearly broke our scoreless tie. Instead, it's a foul ball.
Hey, you guys know me. Hitting's a process of elimination, and I'm eliminating the change.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Royals go down 1-2-3. Still no score. Striding into the box, Anthony Rendon. He's hitless coming into this at-bat, so the hit streak he's been riding is on the line here.
Yeah, he's up in the double digits with it. You know, he wants to keep it going as long as possible, but this very well could be the last chance to do that.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Hey, great job pounding the zone, strike one. When you got a great hitter in the box, got to get ahead. Count leverage is a must.
The windup and the 0-1. Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2. They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
If you've got a good fastball going and they're not handling, keep throwing it. Right there, three fastballs in a row. He gone.
In now, Yasmani Grandal. As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. And here's a swing and a miss as he falls behind nothing and two.
Hey, sped him up, slowed him down. He's got him down 0-2. I think he could pretty much go anywhere right here. I'd be surprised if anything misses over the heart of the plate.
And this will be fouled away. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside. The 1-2.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
The 1-2.
This is exactly the reason why this guy has been so successful and has played this game so long, scrambling pitch after pitch, making this guy work out on the mound.
Bases are empty, one man out. And he fouls this one off. The 2-2 one more time. Gets him looking up around the letters. Digging in, Mike Yastrzemski. First 2 men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. Trying to work that slider to the outer half, but it misses 1-0.
Hey, this one's tied late in the game. As a pitcher right now, you just can't lay a cookie in there 1-0.
Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball. Line hard to the left side, but this will be a foul ball. Now here's a ball hit in the air to straightaway right field. This ball's got plenty of carry to it, and it is out of here. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. As they get on the board first, it's 1-0.
What a great piece of clutch hitting right there to give his boys the lead. Going to put a lot of pressure on the opposition after score with only 6 outs to go.
To the plate now, Luke Voit.
The first base.
Swung on and hit in the air again, deep down the left field line. And that is off the wall, but in foul territory. Foul ball. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. And a curveball taken for strike two.
I know to the fans that probably looked like something good to hit, but unless you're sitting breaking ball right there, I don't care if it's middle of the plate, that's a tough pitch to pull the trigger on.
And on 0-2, he misses with a fastball. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Bases are empty here with 2 men out. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And he just couldn't keep that ball fair as it winds up a long foul ball. Here he comes again, 1-2. Lifted down the line and left. And that will end up a foul ball. The 1-2. Got him swinging in the dirt. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. So just the one hit in the inning, but it's a home run that pushes him out in front. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. The Sky Sox are out on top, 1-0. Settling in now, Dyron Blanco.
Starting to run out of time. They haven't been able to score any runs as we're moving late into this one. A perfect time for this leadoff guy to try to get on base and ignite a rally.
Betts has a read on it, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. Royals batting order turns over and set to go. Adalberto Mondesi. His dominance continues on the mound, but it seems like he might be running on adrenaline only at this point.
Yeah, he's been so great in this one. You want to see him finish what he started, but you also have to start worrying about things like injuries. He's thrown a lot of pitches in this one, and some guys are just more capable of that than others, but not a lot of good things tend to happen when you've worked as hard as he has in this one.
One out, nobody on. Swing and a miss, it's 0-2.
Man, this dude is locked in on the mound. He's throwing each pitch with confidence.
Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Pops him up here on 0-2 as this is drifting toward the right side of the infield. And he'll put this away for the second out.
The designated hitter.
Stepping in, Cam Gallagher. He's gone hitless in this one, Dan, and he's not alone.
No, he's not, Matt. This lineup has had no answer for their opponent on the mound so far.
Third baseman hugging the line here. Now the first pitch. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Back goes Yastrzemski, but he won't have a play. This is down and into the gap. Finally, a little something for them to get excited about.
Yeah, a rally can begin with a single swing of the bat, and this might be their chance right here. They've struggled to produce a lot of runs, but there he is at second base. A shot to the outfield scores him. Then who knows what kind of roll they could get on. Got to take it one good at-bat at a time.
Now out of the dugout comes the manager as he'll make his way towards the mound. And that's going to do it here today for Madison Bumgarner. So as he departs, he can't lose this ball game, but he is responsible for the runner at second, meaning it'd be a no decision if that run comes across to score. Tyler Duffy enters here looking to get the final out before the ninth inning.
Duffy.
Whit Merrifield next to bat, and his guys are looking to erase that donut on the scoreboard with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, Matt, they've been really shut down so far in this one. They've had runners on base, but haven't been able to string anything together.
Trying to hold the lead. Here's the delivery. He pops it up. Voigt ranging into shallow right. He's there, but oh, he clanks it off his glove.
You never want to beat a pitcher that breaks a guy out of a slump, but this guy was too good. You knew it was a matter of time before he started barreling baseball. That gives him a multi-hit game, and I'm sure he's feeling good about it.
So stepping in, Jorge Soler, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
Well, the Royals have been searching for that big hit pretty much all game. It remains to be seen if they can get it, but now sure would be a great time.
Line drive to center field. Kiermaier is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. Royals strand a pair. They're down 1-0. Riding in once again, Bo Bichette, 0-for-2 on the afternoon so far. Here comes the first pitch. Now a swing and a deep drive to left. Looking up is the left fielder. Over the bullpen and gone. A solo shot here to left. Home run number 2 for him on the year, as it's now a 2-0 ball game.
The bullpen is going to have to take care of business in the bottom half of this inning, but they're going to be able to throw a lot freer that they've got that extra run to play with. Insurance runs are always huge.
Scott Barlow, a right-handed reliever standing 6'3", gets the ball now out of the bullpen. At the plate now, Delino DeShields, as he'll watch a slider that stays inside for ball one. Slider stays outside and he falls behind 2-0.
It's never advantageous to fall behind 2-0 as a pitcher, but if you're going to do it, it's far better to do it with a guy down in the bottom of the order. Time for a challenge fastball right here, though.
And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
He'll be fine coming out of the bullpen in this one if he can keep the ball around the knees like that.
The 2-2. And now this ball's lifted in the air down the right field line, but this will get back into the seats, so the count holds at 2-2. And here's a slider. Strike 3 called, and that'll be the first out of the inning.
Now batter.
So digging in now, Kevin Kiermaier. He reached on a fielder's choice previously. First delivery to him on the way. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Bases are empty, one man out. Ground ball left side. Bronco fields it cleanly, and there are 2 away now.
Now batting, the right fielder, Mookie Betts.
So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Mookie Betts. He reached on a fielder's choice previously. First pitch of the at bat.
1-0.
2 out, nobody on. That misses, 2-0. Now he gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. Sent foul again, and after being way ahead, now it's even at 2-2. high in the air out to center field. Blanco is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. So one run on one hit, which was the home run. No errors and no one left on base. 5, 6, and 7 will lead things off in the bottom of the ninth. The Sky Sox are out in front here 2-0. Keone Kella is the man called on to close this one and earn a save in the ninth.
Kella.
Now in the box, Salvador Perez. And then what's gone wrong for this lineup today? They're only 3 outs away from being shut out.
Boy, you know, I just haven't seen a lot of fight in these at-bats. Now, of course, plenty of credit goes to that pitching, but the effort on the offensive side has been pretty lethargic watching from up here in the booth, Matt.
Yeah, I would imagine it feels the same from watching in the stands in this one. Here comes the first pitch. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
Boy, he center cut that fastball. It comes in the high 90s, but that's a dangerous location no matter how hard you're throwing.
And now he'll foul this one off as well to fall behind here. No balls and 2 strikes. Hit in the air out to straightaway left field. Yastrzemski is there, and that's not the start to the bottom of the ninth this crowd was hoping for. One away. And there's a final look at the numbers for the starter in this one. And he'll be very happy with how the day went.
Really strong outing, Matty V. Into the eighth inning without allowing a run. In line for the win, and he certainly deserves a good fate in this one. Hard to imagine he could pitch any better innings 1 through 8 than he did in this one.
Standing in now, Michael Franco. One ball, no strikes to count. Up around the letters with that one for ball 2.
I'm seeing him just a little too amped up out there right now. That's common with hard throwers like him. Running a blazing fastball up there is great, but if you can't harness it, what good does it do you?
One out, nobody on. Great call that time as they caught him thinking fastball. It's 2-1.
That is a pro pitch right there. 2-0 curveball for a strike. You make those kind of pitches, you'll be around for a long time.
He's set, and the 2-1 pitch.
Inside, ball 3.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
The 3-1. Ball 4.
Nope. Ball 4.
Now back. Numbers 56.
Now at the plate, Ryan O'Hearn. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Not even close on that swing. No balls and a strike. The victory would belong to Madison Bumgarner, barring any late turn of events here. Oh, and 2 now as a curveball drops in there for a strike. Oh, and 2 pitches, a curveball that misses 1 and 2.
Count is 1 and 2.
Now And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one.
Oh, man, he's been absolutely getting overmatched at the plate the last couple of games. That's his fifth strikeout in this series alone. So clearly this pitching staff, they figured out how to attack this guy. We'll see if he can make any adjustments.
So now to the plate, Anderson Miller, as he pops the first pitch foul behind the plate. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Tying run at the plate, the 0-1. KC down to their final strike in this one.
And he strikes him out to end it here as they were able to get the possible tying run to the plate but could not cash in.
Well, as a former pitcher, you know I love these low-scoring games as opposed to those slugfests. This was like a throwback game when home runs weren't so common and pitching was really dominant. No complaints here.
A 2-0 finish today. The Sky Sox came through late, taking the lead in the eighth to secure the victory. Madison Bumgarner notches his third win of the year as he racked up 10 strikeouts in the effort. Keone Kella earns the save out of the bullpen, his 13th of the year. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.